大家好，22:10了啊，这个夜深沉啊，夜深人静的时候啊，也是我们思绪可能更清楚的时候。这个美国的左媒啊，Facebook、Twitter、什么 CNN、什么 ABC、CBS，很多啊都偏袒，或者说他们就是那个。以民主党为核心的构建的那个邪恶的或者特权的这么一个利益链啊，既得利益集团的一部分。当然，美国毕竟不是某邪恶国家，美国毕竟有三权分立啊。现在国会站出来了，开始准备匡扶正义、拨乱反正，对他们进行质询了啊，召开听证会了。看看这位参议员啊，他说话非常的有力啊，这个每一击都打在他们的要害处，说的对方啊，就接受质询的这些 CEO 们啊，没有招架之功啊，只有招架之功，没有还手之力。我们听听啊。
I think Twitter's conduct has by far been the most egregious. Mr. Dorsey, does Twitter have the ability to influence elections?
No.
You don't believe Twitter has any ability to influence elections?
No, we are one part of a spectrum of communication channels that people have.
So you're testifying to this committee right now that, that Twitter, when it silences people, when it censors people, when it blocks political speech, that has no impact on elections?
People have choice of other communication channels with which.
Not if they don't hear information. If you don't think you have the power to influence elections, why do you block anything?
Well, we have policies that are focused on making sure that more voices on the platform are possible. We see a lot of abuse and harassment, which ends up silencing people and having them leave from the platform.
All right, Mr. Dorsey, I find your opening questions, your opening answers absurd on their face. Let's talk about the last 2 weeks in particular. As you know, I have long been concerned about Twitter's pattern of censoring and silencing individual Americans with whom Twitter disagrees. But 2 weeks ago, Twitter, and to a lesser extent, Facebook, crossed a threshold that is fundamental in our country. 2 weeks ago, Twitter made the unilateral decision to censor the New York Post in a series of two blockbuster articles, both alleging evidence of corruption against Joe Biden, the first concerning Ukraine, the second concerning communist China. And Twitter made the decision, number one, to prevent users, any user, from sharing those stories. And number two, you went even further and blocked the New York Post from sharing on Twitter its own reporting. Why did Twitter make the decision to censor the New York Post?
We had a hack materials policy that we
When was that policy adopted?
In 2018, I believe.
In 2018, go ahead. What was the policy?
So the policy is around limiting the spread of materials that are hacked. We didn't want Twitter to be a distributor for hack materials. We found that the New York Post, because it showed the direct materials, screenshots of the direct materials, and it was unclear how those were attained, that it fell under this policy. Now,
so in your view, if it's unclear the source of a document, in this instance, the New York Post documented what it said the source was, which it said it was a laptop owned by Hunter Biden and been turned into a repair store. So they weren't hiding what they claimed to be the source. Is it your position that Twitter, when you can't tell the source, blocks press stories?
No, not at all. Our team made a fast decision. The enforcement action, however, of blocking URLs, both in tweets and in DM, in direct messages, we believe was incorrect, and we changed it.
Today, right now, the New York Post is still blocked from tweeting 2 weeks later.
Yes, they have to log into their account, which they can do at this minute, delete the original tweet, which fell under our original enforcement actions, and they can tweet the exact same material, the exact same article, and it would go through.
So, Mr. Dorsey, your ability is you have the power to force a media outlet. Let's be clear. The New York Post isn't just some random guy tweeting. The New York Post has the fourth highest circulation of any newspaper in America. The New York Post is over 200 years old. The New York Post was founded by Alexander Hamilton, and your position is that you can sit in Silicon Valley and demand of the media that you can tell them what stories they can publish, and you can tell the American people what reporting they can hear. Is that right?
No, this was a, you know, every person, every account, every organization that signs up to Twitter agrees to a terms of service. A terms of service is
So media outlets must genuflect and obey your dictates if they wish to be able to communicate with readers. Is that right?
No, not at all. We recognize an error in this policy, and specifically the enforcement.
You're still blocking their posts. You're still blocking their posts. Right now, today, you're blocking their posts.
We're not blocking the posts. Anyone can tweet.
Can the New York Post post on their Twitter account?
If they go into their account.
No is your answer to that. No. Unless they genuflect and agree with your dictates. Let me ask you something. You claimed it was because of a hacked materials policy. I find that facially highly dubious and clearly employed in a deeply partial way. Did Twitter block the distribution of the New York Times' story a few weeks ago that purported to be based on copies of President Trump's tax returns?
We didn't find that a violation of our terms of service and this policy in particular, because it was reporting about the material. It wasn't distributing the material.
Okay, well, that's actually not true. They posted what they reported to be original source materials, and federal law, federal statute makes it a crime, a federal felony, to distribute someone's tax returns against their knowledge. So that material was based on something that was distributed in violation of federal law, and yet Twitter gleefully allowed people to circulate that. But when the article was critical of Joe Biden, Twitter engaged in rampant censorship and silence.
And again, we recognize errors in that policy. We changed it within 24 hours. This is.
But you're still watching the New York Post. You haven't changed it.
We have changed it. They can log into their account, delete the original tweet.
You forced the Politico reporter to take down his post about the New York Post as well. Is that correct?
Within that 24-hour period, yes. But we, you know, as the policy has changed, anyone can tweet.
So Twitter says that you can censor the New York Post, you can censor Politico, presumably you can censor the New York Times or any other media outlet. Mr. Dorsey, who the hell elected you and put you in charge of what the media are allowed to report and what the American people are allowed to hear? And why do you persist in behaving as a Democratic super PAC, silencing views to the contrary of your political beliefs?
Let's give Mr. Dorsey a few seconds to answer that, and then we'll have to conclude this segment.
Well, we're not doing that. And this is why I opened this hearing with calls for more transparency. We realize we need to earn trust more. We realize that more accountability is needed to show our intentions and to show the outcome.
Thank you, Senator.
So I hear the concerns and acknowledge them. We want to fix it with more
transparency.
Thank you, Senator Cruz.
Like 连珠炮一样，是吧？问的对方已经是心慌意乱、面红耳赤了。谎言终究是谎言，不公正的态度、偏袒、拉偏架，是吧？这个已经看得很清楚了。其实他们自己就是这个贪腐利益链，因为他们想赚全球化的钱，而全球化中国是很重要的一环，占的比例份额是相当大，他们不想放弃中国的市场。大家看看啊，民主不是包治百病，即便是三权分立还有舆论监督的第四权利，但是已经被侵蚀、被扭曲、被渗透，已经都走样了，这个走样走得很厉害了。所以现在美国啊，美国三权分立这块金字招牌已经都蒙尘了，上面已经沾尘土了，现在需要赶紧做清理的工作，做清洁的工作，要把这些污垢、把这些藏污纳垢、这些坏人、这些那就是所谓的川普总统说的排干沼泽，把这沼泽地里藏的这些脏东西要给清理掉。这是不是仅仅是美国一国的事儿，这是整个人类、整个世界、整个地球的事儿，必须要做这件事儿。不做的话，将来人类可能会堕入深渊，万劫不复。我们家这小猫在旁边，哎，我说话它仔细的听，但是我刚一抱它，它又想逃走，能逃走吗？不跟朋友们问个好吗？嗯，你说大家好，嗯，走吧，行了。它在旁边也听得可仔细了，那个转动着那个大眼睛，清澈的大眼睛，好像要表达什么意见哈，但是你找它问，他又不置可否，是吧？谢谢大家啊，谢谢。那个待会儿啊，就新的话题咱们接茬聊，接着聊啊，话题是无穷无尽的。这个我的节目啊，这个包罗万象，这个旁证博引，是吧？触类旁通，举一反三，可聊的、能聊的，是吧？咱们擅长聊的都挺多的啊。不谦虚了哈，不谦虚不行哈，不谦虚一定要批评我，是吧？欢迎大家批评啊，我是抛个砖然后引您的玉，抛砖引玉，是吧？谢谢大家啊，谢谢大家捧场。